2014 marks the 102nd season of Marist football. With 31 straight state playoff appearances, two state championships, seven state final appearances, and countless region championships during the span, the Long Blue Line looks forward to seeing the legacy that the 2014 War Eagles will create. As the ghosts of Marist watch over you here at Hugh Spalding Stadium, everyone who ever wore the blue hat wants to know, will this team be the one that brings the program its third ring? While the victories and championships will be talked about for years to come, the program's strength remains in thousands of young men who wore the blue hat and make up the Long Blue Line.
Thank you. Thank you. conversion for Marist. Third and four from the 12. McVay will keep it. McVay at the 10. McVay at the 5. He's in for the touchdown. Sean McVay, the senior, doing what he does best. And Marist answers on their third straight third down conversion.
You know, Sean McVay is a 4-5 guy. He ran that like he's 4-3. He really turned the corner.
Well, talking to the Marist coaches, they said not only is this kid talented, but he's the smartest football player that they've ever seen. Knows when to pitch, knows when to keep it, knows how to run the wishbone, knows
obviously,
how to run the option.
The pitch was there, and he decided to keep it.
He loves to hold the football ball and make it happen right here. A great job finding the hole, and then there's the speed factor, as they were not going to catch him into the end zone, Sean McVay. And that's the guy, if you are Alan Chadwick and know it's in his hands, you feel pretty good, Bo, about your opportunities.
And that a boy to Chris Bradford, the
tackle there on Chris Ashcootie. Second and 16, 30 seconds to go, rolling out McVay. He's in trouble, they'll string him out. McVay trying to get outside, he'll throw it down the field. He's got it in wide open! Touchdown, Marist! Wow, Anderson Russell somehow got behind the secondary, and the War Eagles come up with a huge play. Not had the football yet. Straight ahead, Anderson Russell, no, Scooty, touchdown. The fullback is Scooty into the end zone. Great job on that left side of the line.
Brendan McVay with the read. It was either give it to Scooty or make the pitch. And he made the right decision.
Well, Bo, you're exactly right. A 22nd quarter. Now with 6 minutes left in the third, they're up a touchdown.
And now for the first time, it's Thomas County's opportunity to come from behind.
Daniels fumbles. Ball's on the ground. Marist has it. Wow. Look at the total yards. Marist has come all the way back. Weldon wants to throw. He's in trouble. He'll get around the outside. Still looking to throw. He'll flip it out. It's intercepted. Down the sideline. This is going to go for the touchdown. Chris Ashcootie into the end zone. Oh, boy. 47 yards to the house. And Marist is opening things up. An attendant Marist. Patrick Manning plays for the Bears. Will Heller plays for the Bucks. Perhaps they also taking note. But Marist has done it. They've beaten Thomas County Central. As the clock will wind down on this one, there could not be a happier group of young men than the 37 seniors. Is that right, Bo?
Yeah, 37 seniors. And boy, they've wanted this after the frustration in 4 years past against Thomas County Central. What a great thrill for them to overcome that and be able to get this tremendous victory.
All right, Steak, thank you. Now, Coach Chadwick, you guys are headed to the state championship game for the first time in 14 years. And you also beat a team that has been kind of a thorn in your side for quite some time. What does this mean to you and your school?
Well, certainly this is a huge win for our football team and our program, our players, our fans, our coaches. I just can't say enough. You know, we're going for a state championship, and that's the ultimate goal, and that's what we've got our focus on. But this was a huge hurdle for us, getting over this hump of winning in the Dome and beating Thomas County. It makes it doubly good.
McNerney in motion. Pitch goes to Patrick Sullivan. Sullivan's got a first down and more. Sullivan down the sideline across the 50 and finally brought down at the 39-yard line.
Down for a touchdown on their first possession.
Farmer on the keeper pitches to Patrick Sullivan. They had success with this earlier, and Sullivan gets out to the 35-yard line.
And I believe that 42.
Handoff, fullback, Matt Connors, gaping hole. Connors down to the 21-yard line. Second down and six. Pitch, Sullivan. Sullivan slips out of a tackle. Sullivan dives for the pylon. Did he score? Touchdown. Patrick Sullivan. 18-yard touchdown run, and Maris has a 13-0 lead. He's going to be a college baseball player at the University of Georgia. He rolls to his left. Pump fake. Going deep for Langhorn, and Langhorn caught it! Wow, what a catch! Caught it right over A.J. Bouye. Pitch, Sullivan. Got a block from McNerney. Sullivan down the sideline, touchdown! They've been running that play all night. Tucker hasn't stopped it yet. Anticipate a much more tightly contested matchup than this, but it has been all Maris tonight. Kyle Farmer weaving his way through that Tucker defense down inside the 20. And that'll be the final play. Alan Chadwick saw it coming, and he got out of the way. He didn't want anything to do with that. Well, that's about the only thing that didn't go right for the Maris players tonight. That's the only thing they missed. Let's check in with Brandon Adams.
All right, Coach, you dodged the Gatorade shower. That was pretty snifty maneuvers there.
I had somebody cue me off, and I just looked around at the right time, so I was lucky there, too.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Hugh Spalding Stadium and the playoff contest between Marist War Eagles and the Sprayberry Yellow Jackets.
Guys, this is one of those moments in your life, okay? This time of the season, it's playoffs, the regular season's over, it's time to start getting after somebody.
Squash that shadow of doubt! Drive that dark of doubt away! There is no doubt, ever, in a Maris football player, ever, cast that shadow of doubt away! Get up to that!
Get up to that tonight!
Yeah, come on! Yeah. Sing a new song tonight! Sing a new song tonight! Sing a new song tonight! Leave no doubt and get up to that!
FSU, 1, 2, 3, FSU!
What time is it? It's War Eagle time, man. Absolutely.
I think this is the 27th straight year we've been in the playoffs. One of the things we do is we always paint the end zones. So when we put it in our turf field, the player said, Coach, let's not put anything in the end zones. So you can see we did the diamonds, stayed with Maris tradition, but it's a great tradition. It's sort of what we call the long blue line. What a great high school atmosphere.
The quarterback kept the ball. It was an option to whether he could pitch it or keep it. He kept it, and he went over and did not pitch it because he saw that the the defense reacted to the fake, so he kept it and he went across the goal line. Touchdown.
They've been rolling for approximately 3 minutes.
6 points, Marist. Heck of a catch from Penn Davenport, a senior. So we get the extra point here, now we're up by seven against a good football team.
21-7. Yeah, they're doing great. Yeah, this is supposed to be a really good team, so it's looking good.
Oh, man. Oh, been a big one, hadn't it? It's been huge. Great crowd, great atmosphere. And the kids really, you know, when they pick it up, they play together, it just makes you feel really good. Coach has done a great job, so thank you.
Marist takes the field first. It's a high snap, but he gets it. And it's blocked.
Oh, my God. It's blocked.
It was blocked. It sure was. And who was that, Michael Toner? Michael Toner in to block the punt. He was right there. That was big.
That was big.
Willis. He gives it to Gray King. There's a hole, and he busts it, and he crosses the 50. Man, that's 21. Now it's about 13. Miles wants to throw. He does throw. He's got a man, and he completes it to Greg Toboda.
Miles on the center.
Gray King's in motion. There's a pitch to him. He turns a corner, and he's in for a touchdown right off the bat. Go get him. Go get him. Go get him. No, he dropped the ball. Oh, he batted down. Was that Gray King?
That's the game.
That's the ball game.
That's the game.
Marist wins 43-37.
In how many overtimes?
In five overtimes.